Today in this class we'll be learning about the ventilator strategies, that is modes of delivery of oxygen and the ventilators. What we have seen in the recent exams that lot of questions generally are getting framed on this topic, either as a part of critical care medicine or maybe respiratory medicine, or depending upon the situation. So there are certain important zones that need to be understood, as this is somewhat of a advanced topic which generally UG students are generally not exposed or not taught about in their UG days. So it requires a special effort for the students to take care for learning of these topics. And especially I would advise guys that whenever you go for your ward rounds or whenever you go to your ICU setups, you just go and see some of the very basic aspects of how oxygen delivery systems are there, how ventilator works, what are the different parts of ventilators. We'll be going through some of the very basic aspects. Whatever they ask you as far as your exam and the MCQ is concerned, they ask you about very simple and basic stuff, but you should be aware about those basic stuff. So we will first start with in the ventilator section or ventilator strategy. We will start with what is called as what are the different modes where the patient requires some extra amount of oxygen. So there are certain important disorders, some are chronic, some are acute. In this, patient will require ventilatory support. Some are chronic like COPD, chronic asthma, then interstitial lung diseases. These are all, then pneumoconiosis. These are all very chronic disorders that might require a long-term oxygen therapy. And then there are certain disorders where the patient can suddenly land up into acute respiratory failure, where the patient requires like ARDS, then a complication of a very severe pneumonia. In all these cases, the patient or near drowning, patient will require a acute ventilatory support. So we will see today in this class about all those strategies, about all those methods and modes of respiration, because these have been one of the common questions that are getting asked in the recent exam patterns, whether it is NEET, JIPMER or AIIMS. So we will first start with some of the important oxygen delivery systems. We'll go upon go according to who delivers the least amount of oxygen and who delivers the maximum amount of oxygen. Then we'll move on to the non-invasive part of the ventilatory or respiratory support, and then we'll move on to the invasive part, that is via the endotracheal intubation. Then one important complication that arises, guys, in this ventilatory supported patients, where there is ventilatory support is given to the patient, is ventilator associated pneumonias. So we are not dealing with ventilator supported or ventilator associated pneumonias and infections in this section. We'll deal it with those topics in the respiratory medicine, where along with the other pneumonias, that is hospital acquired pneumonias, community acquired pneumonias, we'll also study about the ventilator associated pneumonias, the most common organisms involved, and the antibiotic prophylaxis that needs to be given to the patient. So first and foremost, the important method or the mode of delivery is what we call as nasal cannula. So nasal cannula is something which gives the least amount of oxygen. It delivers 1 to 6 liters per minute of O2, and least delivery is of O2 is given by nasal cannula. Least delivery of O2 is given by the nasal cannula. They can also get you this stuff. As far as this stuff is concerned, they might also ask you an image based question. So a simple image based question might just be given, and they might ask you, what is this? So this is what a nasal cannula looks. There are certain tubes that are put into the nose. So you might have already seen this, guys, if you remember that movie, Fault in My Stars. So in that movie, the same apparatus where the girl is having this nasal cannula for continuous oxygen delivery and she's carrying an oxygen cylinder along with her. So this is generally given for patients who are having very chronic disorders like for the COPD and interstitial lung disorders. So all these patients require a continuous delivery. In these patients, we give a nasal cannula. The next step is face mask. So this face mask has a higher delivery. It delivers oxygen 8 to 10 liters per minute of O2 delivery is given by this face mask. And this is what a face mask looks like. So this can also be an image-based MCQ for you all. So you can see that the mask is applied onto the face and the patient is breathing and the oxygen is getting delivered. Then the next is what is called as non-rebreathers. The name itself tells you it delivers 10 to 15 ml or 10 to 15 liters of oxygen per minute. Per minute of O2 is given by a non-rebreather. This is what a non-rebreather looks like, guys. So you can just see in this image, this is basically a non-rebreather. So what it does, we are exhaling and we are inhaling the air. So depending upon that, we have a setup where which is called as a non-rebreather. And then there is a major differentiating line from here. Then you have the most important method that is called as non-invasive positive pressure ventilation. Non-invasive positive pressure ventilation. Ventilation or NIPP. This NIPP gives a highest oxygen delivery. It delivers 20 liters of oxygen per minute of O2 is given. This is obviously a non-invasive procedure, so there is no endotracheal tube that is involved. And along with it, what are the different methods of this non-invasive ventilator? Number one, it is high flow nasal cannula. High flow nasal cannula. And second one is CPAP. And the third one is BiPAP. So you'll hear about these terminologies CPAP and BiPAP more often. Then, as far as CPAP and BiPAP are concerned, there are two important contraindications to this non-invasive CPAP and BiPAP. They are altered mental status and asthma or vomiting. Sorry. So, if the patient is vomiting and the patient has an altered mental status, the non-invasive positive pressure ventilation, that is CPAP and BiPAP, are contraindicated. So these three, all of them, or these four of them, are what is called as the non-invasive modalities. And later on, followed by this, is what we call as the invasive modality. And in the invasive modality, we will see, guys, that what are the different modes and how do we take care of those modes later on. Invasive is done by putting an endotracheal intubation. So let us first move to the first mode and try and understand this first mode. This is called as CPAP. So the CPAP is also, we have seen, it is called as the continuous positive airway pressure. Continuous positive airway pressure. So as the name tells you guys, that this is a mode of ventilation where we are giving a constant pressure, and this continuous pressure is given. So what is it? It doesn't provide any other pressure above it. So what we will just see what this CPAP is. So on this axis, we have the pressure. On this axis, we have the volume. So this is our typical CPAP. What is this? This is pressure. And this is time. On this axis you have time, on this axis you have pressure. So what you give a continuous positive pressure. So there is always a continuous positive pressure. So this positive pressure is called as PEEP, positive end expiratory pressure. So the machine provides this, pressure always, and the patient breathes above this pressure. So machine provides this pressure. And the patient breathes above this pressure. So there is always a constant pressure that is being provided by the machine, and the patient is breathing above this pressure. So this is what is the PEEP. So what is this pressure support over PEEP? So what we have is, we have the PEEP and we have the pressure support over the PEEP. So you have the pressure support over PEEP and you have the PEEP. So positive end expiratory pressure, here we will write that this is 0/5. So in this case, what the machine is doing is, it is only providing PEEP, but is not providing any additional pressure above the PEEP. So for what is this used? This is used for different purposes. Here we can just understand this with the help of this diagram. You can just see that in this diagram, in this figure, what we have is that the patient is taking in air through a CPAP, which is having an O2 reservoir. It is connected to a O2 cylinder along with the air. So depending upon what kind of a mixture of air and O2 we require, that is FiO2, it will be delivered accordingly. Then you have a pressure gauge over here that will see for the pressure. That is, here the PEEP we are providing. So this PEEP here is 5 centimeters of water. This pressure is always provided. So we look for this pressure. There is a high flow that is going on, and this is connected to a mask, and later on there is this resistance to the exhalation. There is this resistance to the exhalation that is called as the PEEP valve, and it is this PEEP valve that helps in generation of this resistance, helps in generation of the PEEP or a pressure, and above this pressure the patient will always be breathing. So this is what you can say is the continuous positive airway pressure. Where is this used? This is used in multiple settings. So the usage, number one, obstructive sleep apnea. It is commonly used in obstructive sleep apnea, then in obese patient, then cardiogenic pulmonary edema, congestive heart failure, pneumonias, and type 1 respiratory failure. In all these cases, the CPAP mode is used. CPAP is providing a positive, no extra pressure support over the PEEP. It only provides the PEEPs. This is CPAP. Then we come to the next mode, that is called as BiPAP. As the name itself tells us, guys, what is a BiPAP? BiPAP is something which provides pressure support over PEEP. Provides pressure support over PEEP. And also it provides the PEEP. And also PEEP. So you have the BiPAP providing two important pressures. Pressure support over PEEP as well as the PEEP. This is called as BiPAP. We'll just see with the help of this flowchart or this diagram how the ventilatory support is given for the patients of BiPAP. So this is our pressure and this is our time. So you have time, you have pressure, and this is something which is the ventilator is providing or the support is providing. This pressure is PEEP. This pressure is PEEP. So how much is the PEEP? Generally the PEEP is 5 centimeters of water. So it is providing PEEP, and along with this PEEP it is also providing one more pressure, that is a pressure support above the PEEP. This is the pressure support above the PEEP. This is the pressure support above the PEEP. So this is PEEP and this is PS above PEEP. Now depending upon the requirement, the patient will be taking inspiration and expiration. So during inspiration it is providing an extra pressure support, followed by the expiration, then again followed by the inspiration. So during inspiration there is an additional or an advanced or a extra support, pressure support, that is given by the machine. So what is this support? The support is, suppose here it is 10 centimeters of water. So here in BiPAP it becomes pressure support and the PEEP. So the pressure support by PEEP is 10 by 5. So 10 by 5 means PEEP is 5 and the pressure support provided is above the PEEP. Here you can just note this diagram, guys, you can just appreciate that how this basically intraalveolar pressure, it changes during the BiPAP. You can just note here that this diagram, this is the pressure that is there and this is the PEEP. So in the BiPAP what is happening is that there is a constant pressure support. So during inspiration the pressure is going up and during expiration it comes down, and there is always a constant pressure that is always maintained. So this